Hi guys, it's Maggie. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video, as you can see by the title, is so different than anything that I normally do on my channel. I'm gonna be showing you guys my designer bag collection, and I get so many requests to do this on Instagram, and I always get comments on my videos that you guys wanna see this, so I was contemplating it for a while just because, I don't know, being the person like behind the camera sitting down and just showing you guys all the bags that I have, it can be a little bit weird, and I know that like weird for people watching it. I know a lot of people like have opinions on this type of stuff, and when people do these types of videos, they do like this big disclaimer, blah blah blah, which I'm not gonna do, because if you don't wanna watch this video, then you don't have to watch it. If you're not interested in it, then you don't have to watch it. I'm not forcing you to. There's so many other videos on my channel, but for the people that do wanna see this video, I'm super excited to be showing it to you guys, just because I feel like people in life have different interests and things that they love and stuff like that. And I know some people can be into like music, concerts, cars, jewelry, whatever it may be. People do have their own individual interests, and mine just happens to be bags and jewelry. I love investing in really nice bags just because I know that they are gonna be amazing quality. They're gonna last me forever. I'm gonna one day be able to hand them down to my daughters, and they're gonna be vintage. And I just feel like with designer bags, they get better with age, truly, because they really never go out of style and they never really lose their value at all. You can wear them so many different ways with so many different outfits, and I just think that they truly are a really amazing investment, and I like investing my money in things that I'm gonna be having for a very long time. So yeah, I just really, really like bags. And also, another thing I wanted to say before we start this video is I will link the bags below, and also I will, if they are available, I don't know, some of the styles I know aren't available anymore, but I will try my best to find all of them, and I will also have the names of them on the screen just because I don't know them off the top of my head, but I will go through and find the exact names so you guys can look them up and stuff, because I know when bags are unavailable, you can still find them like on the RealReal. There are a ton of like secondhand designer consignment shops online where you can find a bunch of items. So I will do that for you guys, and also if you are still interested in any of these bags, I will try to find like a dupe or a affordable lookalike, like a look for less. I love doing that. I love searching the internet for bags that look like designer bags but obviously are a fraction of the price. So I will do that for you guys because I understand and I know that they, like, bags are very expensive, especially designer bags, and not everybody can afford them. Trust me, I was in that position once, and I did not buy any designer bags until I had enough money and I made my own money to be able to buy them. So I worked really hard for all the ones that I have, and I'm really proud of them, I guess you could say, and I just really like them. And enough of the talking, let's just get on into the video. If you guys aren't subscribed, make sure you're subscribed and follow me on Instagram. It is always linked at the top of the description. And without further ado, let's get started. So I kind of have them like categorized right now, not by brand, not by like the time that I got them, just because I thought that it would be a little bit more organized this way. So I guess we could start off, we'll start with my YSL bags. So this is the first one right here. It is this huge canvas tote bag. I love this bag so much. I saw so many people that had it this summer that like traveled with it, and I just think that it goes amazing with any outfit. It's just like a big canvas tote bag with these leather straps, and then the inside just has a little zipper pocket. I love bringing this bag with me when I travel, like going on the plane. It fits everything that I need, and I feel like it's one of those bags that like doesn't get extremely heavy when you carry it, which is nice. And I like just bringing it to the pool, being able to put like my book in it, sunglasses, sunscreen, my towel, all of that. It just fits everything. And the bottom of it I really love because it's rectangular, so it stands flat and doesn't like slouch over or anything. So it's just a really amazing bag. I love this one, and I got this summer, and I've just got so much use out of it, and I really just love the style. I think that you can like dress it up and dress it down. And inside of the bag, I actually have my two other YSL bags just because I wanted to kind of keep them together. The first one is, or the next one is, this little black kind of envelope wallet bag, and inside it just has the strap, which is just this long gold strap. It's super cute and small, just black and gold. which I love. And then the inside looks like this. It just has a little place for your cards, your ID, if you wanna go out. It literally fits your phone, your lip gloss, and your ID and money. It has a little zipper pocket right here, so you can like zip your cash or anything in there that you don't wanna lose, and then it just closes like that. Just super cute little simple bag, goes with everything. I really love that one. I got it when I was in Italy last summer, so it just really means a lot to me. It reminds me of my trip there. I remember seeing it and I just thought that it was the cutest little bag ever, and it is really helpful when I go out at night, especially like to bars in Boston. I don't want to be like carrying this big bag with me, so that one's perfect. It's so tiny and it just fits everything that you need. And the next bag I have right here is just another YSL. It's a like gunmetal metallic gray silver color, and I really love this bag. I love the strap because you can wear it long like this, or you could even wear it short like on your shoulder or crossbody. I really love it. And then the inside is so big. It has two huge compartments, one right here and then one in the back, and then also in the middle it just has a little zipper area. I'm like checking all the zippers to see if I forgot anything last time I used it, but this is just what it looks like. A gorgeous bag. I love using this one during the fall and winter just because it's more like cool toned, and I got this for my birthday last year for myself, my 22nd birthday, and I just love it. And I just think that it adds just like such a nice touch to your outfit. Just like a plain black outfit and then throw this on, it adds like not a pop of color, but just like a little something. And next we have my Gucci bags. So this one right here, I remember last year I was so obsessed with like the mini backpack trend that was going on, so I had to have this one. And this is definitely one of those purchases where, you know, people do those videos on YouTube like your five best and your five worst designer purchases. I feel like this one right now I don't get any use out of, which it makes me really sad. It just like sits in my closet. I'm using like different bags, but I feel like it's one of those that is gonna just age really well and then come back, and just I can't wait for it to be like old and vintage. I just feel like it's gonna be super cool, but I still love it, obviously. Just don't use it at the moment, but it's just my black Gucci backpack, and the inside is so big. It fits so much stuff. I brought this with me to Italy last year, and it was the most helpful bag ever walking around Europe. I could just like put it on my back. It carried everything that I needed, and it just looks so good with any outfit. I really, really love it. So this is the backpack right here, and the straps, you can adjust them. You can make them long, you can make them short, whatever you prefer. And the next Gucci bag I have is my first, actually, well, my first ever designer bag, which I'll show you guys next, is my Louis Vuitton duffel bag. But I feel like that's not like an everyday bag, so that's kind of one thing that I got to use like when I traveled for weekends and stuff like that, which I'll talk about. But this was my first ever bag that I bought as an adult, and it is just the white classic Gucci bag, and it has gold detailing, and I am obsessed with this bag. I love it so much. It means so much to me. I got it in Miami last year when I was on one of my first trips ever for YouTube, and I just feel like it has a lot of value to me. It means a lot to me, and it's just something that I will always like cherish forever. It'll give me all of the memories from Miami last year, and I just really love it. And it opens up, I forget, oh yeah, you press like the little button at the bottom and then just opens up like this, and the inside just has a little zipper, and then just as normal, open like that. Just love this bag. It is so timeless and gorgeous and elegant, and I think it's so classy. I just really love it. You can wear it like this on your shoulder, or you can also wear it crossbody and make it super long like that. But I just adore this bag. I just really love this bag, and it's hard because you can only really wear this color during the summer, but I know that white and cream are coming in, and they're gonna be really in style and like trending this fall, so I'm super excited to start using this bag. I need to use my bags more and like branch out. I just feel like they sit in their box with the dust bag in my closet just because my closet area is so small that I kind of have to like stack them all at the top, and I just use whatever bag that I'm currently using, and I use it every single day. I don't really switch them up. So I'm really excited to get older and have like a bag closet so I can like walk in and physically see all of my bags and like change them out every day, like with to match whatever outfit I'm wearing, which I don't do right now. I really don't put the effort into it, but one day I will, and we'll do that. But yeah, so this is that bag. And then my last Gucci bag I have isn't your typical like bag like I've showed you guys before, but it is still Gucci and I really like it, and it's meaningful to me because I bought it in Italy at the Gucci Garden in Florence, and it's just what it looks like. It is a little like reusable tote bag, and it just says Gucci Garden and then has this eye on the front, and I just love the color, how it's pink, and I love like the black detailing. This bag is so cute. I love using it like when I'm going to a workout class, just throwing some stuff in it, or like whenever I just need to have like a little bag. I just love this one, and you can only get it at the Gucci Garden, so I had to get it. It was only like $50, 50 euros, and I just knew that it was one of those things, like a collector's item that would remind me of my trip and stuff, so I have that. And then next, for our next category before we get into like miscellaneous bags, we have Louis Vuitton. So this is my latest bag, the one that I've been using. You guys have been seeing this all over my Instagram, my channel, and it is the Louis Vuitton black leather bum bag. I am obsessed with this bag. I've wanted a bum bag for a while, which is like this style, like a belt bag, fanny pack, waist bag, whatever you want to call it. And I've wanted one for so long. I just couldn't find the right one, which one I wanted. I feel like a lot of them are very small, and for me, I need a lot of room in my bag. I need to be able to carry my phone, my Laneige lip mask, my camera, maybe a pair of sunglasses, and my little wallet with my keys. Like, I have a lot of stuff to carry with me always, because of especially my camera, and I'm always vlogging and stuff, so I couldn't find one that was big enough, and I had searched everywhere, and I kind of wanted to get one from Chanel. I really liked them, and I saw one before. Lauren Elizabeth had it, and it had like gold detailing or whatever, and I just thought that it was really pretty, so I went to Chanel, and I tried looking for one, and just the styles that they had, I really did not love, and I was like, why would I spend all this money on a bag when I don't love it, but I love that style. Then I came across this one right here, which is the Louis Vuitton one, and my friend Kenzie Meads has it, and I used it when we were in Laguna together, and I was so obsessed with it. It fit so much stuff because I was wearing a green dress one day, and the only bag I had with me was my like neon green Balenciaga, and I was like, I can't wear these bags, like this bag with this dress. It was just a lot of green. So she was like, oh Maggie, like I have an extra black bag, you can use it. And I was like, wait, oh my god, I'm so obsessed with this. It fit all my stuff. It was so cute, so effortless, how you just like put it over. This is how I wear it, like right on my chest. I didn't have to worry about anything. I could fit everything inside, and it was just the best. Later that day, or later that week, we actually went to a mall that had a bunch of designer stores, and we were going in them because I really wanted to find a bum bag. And I looked at Chanel again. Again, there was nothing. So then we went to Louis Vuitton, and I saw this bag, and they had it in like a royal blue color, and I love royal blue right now, but I was like, you know what, I feel like I should just get the black one instead of the blue one, because I'm gonna get so much more use out of it, and I have ever since I got it. I'm so obsessed with it. I love it so, so much, and I just love the detailing, how it has like the rainbow on the zipper, and the inside is so big, it holds everything you could think of. It's so huge, and I just adore it, and the gold detailing is absolutely gorgeous. So I had to copy Kenzie and get one for myself, and I've been using it every day since I got it, and I love it, love it, love it. And it also comes in white too, which I noticed. And next, from Louis Vuitton, this was my first bag, which I was telling you guys before. It is the Keep All 55, just your typical duffel bag for traveling. I have the one with the strap, which makes it so much more helpful, but these bags are so heavy, and I feel like they're good for like a little weekend away, maybe like one or two nights, but at the airport they are very, very heavy. So if you have a bag like that, I would recommend probably using like a carry-on suitcase if you could traveling. It just makes it so much easier, because I do find that they get very heavy and they're very annoying to carry. But I love it for when I'm just going to like Tyler's house, my boyfriend, on the weekends, and I can just throw in like a few things that I need, my skincare, and then just go. It just makes like a really good overnight bag. So that was my first bag. I just have it in the monogram canvas, and I love it. It's just very classic, and it ages really well. When I first got it, it had like light, but I think it's called patina leather, and then it just gets like darker over time. So this is just what it looks like. Love it so much. And yeah, so now on to our miscellaneous bags. This one right here, super cute. I love this style. It is coming back right now, like the little mini vintage bags. And this one is a vintage Ferragamo bag. I got this at a consignment store in my boyfriend's town. It's called Chic Consignment in Andover. And I went in and they were putting this out on the floor and I saw it and I immediately was like, I need that. So it's so cute. I just love how it's so effortless and like chic. You can just throw it over your shoulder, wear it with like a white tank top and a pair of like oversized distressed jeans and sneakers and like a little pair of glasses. I just love this style right now and I'm obsessed with this bag. I love it, love it. The inside just has like a lot of room in it, and then there's also like this front pocket right here which has stuff in it. Yeah, little front pocket. So it's super cute and I love the silver detailing and everything, and it was brand new when I got it with the dust bag and everything. No one had ever used it. It was in perfect condition, so I like had to get it. And the next bag I have is just this red one right here. When I was getting my first bag, the Gucci one that I showed you guys before, the white one, I had wanted that one in red for so long, and I just held off on getting it because I was like, I can't have my first bag be red. I'm never gonna use it. So about a year later, I decided to get this bag, which is my red Fendi bag. And again, it just has kind of like the similar strap as a bunch of my bags have, like the Gucci and the YSL one, where you can wear it like over your shoulder or you can wear it crossbody and it just gets super long. But this bag is absolutely gorgeous. It just has little F's all over it and then has like this silver and gold detailing at like the clasp or whatever you want to call that. And then the inside is so big, and I even have a sticker in it from Cha Cha Matcha from last time I went to New York. And yeah, so this is what the inside looks like. It has two compartments. This bag holds so much stuff. This is one of my favorite bags that I own. I just think that a red bag really does go with everything. If you're like me and you wear a lot of neutral colors, it just adds a nice pop of color. I am obsessed with the gold detailing. I just think that this bag is so classy. I really love it. And yeah, so that is my Fendi bag. And then I actually have another red bag right here, which isn't like a designer brand name, but I got it. It is handmade. I got it in Italy last summer in, it was a little island. I want to say it was called, I forget what it was called, but it was in Venice. But I forget. I don't know what it's called. It'll come to me and I'll put it right here on the screen. But anyway, I got this bag. It is handmade. And this is just what it looks like. I know that this style has like a name to it. They made Chanel bags like this last summer. You guys were all sending me messages and photos on Instagram showing me. So this is what it looks like. It's just like a knit handmade bag. It's so beautiful with a gold strap. And I just love it. I think that it is just, again, so meaningful because it was handmade in Italy and I bought it at a little store on the water and I just thought that it was so cute. So I just wanted to include that one really quickly. And last but not least, I think, yeah, this is my last bag. You guys know this bag. It is my famous Balenciaga neon green mini camera bag. This bag is so cute. I love this bag so much. I think it's the perfect size. It is so mini and it is neon. I still love neon, but neon green is my favorite. If I want like a really bold, bright pop of color, I love like a good neon green, neon yellow for like the spring and summer. And yeah, so this is my little bag. You guys know that it kind of got ruined when I was wearing a Free People dress like a month and a half ago, maybe 2 months ago, and it was black and it ended up like transferring some dye onto the back of the bag, which I kind of got off a little bit, but you can still see it is a little bit black on the edges, which is okay. I did my best to be able to clean it, and I actually asked the worker at Balenciaga last week when I was getting my Louis Vuitton bum bag how to clean it, and they told me to get a specific leather cleaner. So I'm gonna get that and then try to clean it up a little bit more. But it's so cute, I love it so much, and I just love how it's just so simple and just says like Balenciaga right on the front, and then you open it up and it's just plain on the inside. Nothing to it. Fits my phone, camera, everything for it even being so mini. I just love the color. I love the style, and it also comes in a bunch of different colors, which is really cute, and I just love just like the simplicity of it. But it also like gives your outfit some character, and you can really like express your personality or your style with this bag. I don't know, it's super cute. I just really like it. So this is the last bag that I have to show you guys today, but I hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope that you liked seeing which bags that I have. I honestly don't have anything bad to say about any of them. I really truly love all of them. I don't regret buying any of them. The way that I look at it, like I said earlier, was they are just investments and they're only gonna get better with age. They're gonna age really well and be very vintage and cool when I'm older, and I'll be able to pass them down to my daughters and stuff. And I feel like that'll be like really meaningful, because when my mom was growing up, her house actually burnt down and she lost everything. So she doesn't have like anything from her childhood when she was growing up. So yeah, I just want to be able to like save some pieces and be able to like pass them down to my daughters, since that's something that my mom had always like wished that she could do, but she like lost everything. So yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, I will link some dupes and like looks for less down below, because I know a lot of you guys would be interested in that, and I love looking online to find bags that look similar, like give off the similar style, but obviously are a fraction of the price. So I will do that for you guys, and I hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you are subscribed if you're not already, and follow me on Instagram. I thought my camera just shut off because I've been filming for so long, but follow me on Instagram. It's always linked. I love you so, so much. I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.